In this video, we will learn about the short-run production function, specifically total product, average product, and marginal product. By the end of this video, you should be able to calculate total product, average product, and marginal product. Also, you'll be able to plot and have a better understanding of the total product, average product, and marginal product curves. The first thing we do when calculating product is consider our variable input, which is labor in this case. Remember, we consider capital fixed in the short run, so the only variable changing is labor. For each additional unit of labor, we'll see a change in total output. For the first worker, they bring total output to 1 unit. The second increases the total to 4. The third brings us to 9, and this continues all the way to the 9th worker, who, along with the others, produces a total of 37 units. Next, we take a look at the average product at each quantity of labor. Our first worker's total product is 1, and dividing that by 1 gives us an average product of 1. We do the same thing to the others as labor increases. 2 workers produce 4 units, which results in an average product of 2. We divide 4 units by the 2 workers, and each worker produces an average of 2 units. Continuing this down to the 9th worker, we see that 9 workers contribute an average of 4.11 units. This is interesting because up until our 6th worker, our average output is about 5 units per worker. It's now decreasing, and we'll have to explain why. Next, let's look at marginal product and see what each additional unit of labor adds to the total. Marginal product, or the additional product produced by the next worker, is measured by the change in total production divided by the change in the quantity of labor. The quantity of labor is consistently 1 in this example, so we only need to look for the change in the quantity of production as each worker is added. As we increase labor from 0 to 1, we increase our total production from 0 units to 1 unit. Therefore, marginal product is 1. Bringing in the second worker increases total production to 4 units from 1 unit, which means their marginal product is 3 units. The third worker adds an additional 5 units, the fourth an additional 7 units, and the fifth an additional 9 units. However, something interesting starts to happen after the fifth worker. The additional 6th worker actually contributes just 5 units. The 7th worker's contribution is just 4. The 8th contributes an additional 4 units, and the 9th worker actually reduces overall production. To understand why, we have to recall our pizza shop example. After hiring so many employees, eventually the workspace is crowded and inefficiency arises. Potentially, workers get in each other's way. Let's bring all that information together on one table here. I'm going to use this data to plot the curves for total product, average product, and marginal product. The final graph looks something like this, but I'll walk you through each curve step by step. Using the information from the table, we can see that the total product line increases up until the 9th worker, in which case it starts to fall. The average product rises up until the 5th worker, at which point it is constant, including the 6th worker, but starts to decline as diminishing returns set in. The marginal product curve rises as each additional worker adds more than the previous one, but the hiring of the 6th worker starts to bring down marginal product. It looks like productivity is impacted so severely that by the 9th worker, marginal product is negative. I want to draw your attention to 2 specific points related to the marginal product curve. First is the addition of the 5th worker, who is able to increase total production and thus marginal production significantly. However, beyond this point, the employment of additional labor causes additional returns to decrease. Marginal returns are still positive up until we employ the 9th worker, who is now having an adverse impact on production, causing it to decrease. Thus, we can see that this diagram can be broken into 3 distinct phases: increasing marginal returns, decreasing marginal returns, and negative marginal returns. You should have a firm understanding why marginal returns behave in such a manner in order to fully grasp the behavior of cost curves, which we will cover next. Hopefully, you're more comfortable calculating total product, average product, and marginal product by now. It's quite easy to find worksheets to practice the calculation, and I'd also encourage you to try and graph the information you process. This will help you really get to grips with the behavior of the curves and understand why diminishing marginal returns of labor occurs in the short run. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. I hope you found this explanation helpful, and while it's difficult at first, it will get easier as you revise and practice. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.